Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and very good morning. Okay, basically today I will cover for topic 3. Actually, we have done topic 1, topic 2. And now we go for topic 3, which is quality in customer-supplier relationship. Again, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum and a very good morning. Okay, kalau kita lihat dekat sini, saya mistranslatekan sedikit, iaitu quality in customer supplier relationship bermaksud hubungan dalam mengekalkan dari segi bagaimana pelanggan ataupun kita punya pembeli dan macam mana hubungan quality tersebut dengan supplier ataupun pengedar barangan-barangan ataupun resources pada kita. Okay, tak kira lah bahan mentah ke ataupun dari segi bentuk produk. Jadi untuk kita memproses mengeluarkan produk kita, maka kita perlu ada hubungan yang berkualiti. Okay, apa tu yang hendak kita kupas dalam topik ni? Okay, so the first slide ni dinyatakan tentang the value of customer. Apakah nilai-nilai yang ada pada seorang ataupun pelanggan kita? Okay, the only value your company will ever create is the value that come from the customer. Okay, the one you have now and the ones you will have in the future. And businesses succeed by getting, keeping and growing customers. Customers are the only reason you build the factories, hire the employees, schedule meetings, lay fiber optic lines or engage in any business activity. Without customer, you don't have a business. So this is according to Don Peppers and Martha Rogers. So basically bila kita ceritakan tentang nilai-nilai yang perlu ada pada customer ni adalah betapa mahal mereka di sudut pandangan suatu perniagaan ataupun sebuah syarikat ataupun perniagaan tersebut. Kenapa Miss cakap macam ni? Sebab kalau kita tengok daripada the statement ataupun kita kata quote daripada Don Peppers and also Martha Rogers ni, dia menggambarkan kepentingan bahawa pelanggan tu perlu ada. Okay, the importance of the customer. Okay, and you can see from the first statement saying that the one you have now means the existing customer and the one you will have in the future. It means that you have to, the company will ever to create the value. Value added when the customer buy the products from your company, they feel appreciated, they feel recognized, they feel that satisfaction, that is the most important thing. So the value is come from the customer, and the customer actually predicting whether they're still loyal to your company in the existing, in the meantime, okay, and whether it also can become in the future. Because we do not know from their words of mouth, okay, they can actually spread and telling other people's, other friends, family members, and also the clicks on how well your products or services, right? So business succeed by getting, keeping and growing customers. So this is the process, okay, whereby why the reason you have to make the business. So because number one, because it getting, because the numbers of customer is rising, okay, and how you want to keeping, meaning to say how you want to make sure that the customer will be sustained and maintain and retain. Okay, meaning to say macam mana kita nak mengekalkan supaya customer tu, pelanggan tu sentiasa ada bersama dengan your business. Okay, and also growing customer. Growing meaning to say they have more and more new customer who like to buy, okay, use your services, buy your product because of your good reputation, okay, good rapport. And of course the customer are the only reason. Dia kata disebabkan itu adalah sebab utama, the main reason that you build the factory, the reason you have to develop your plantation, okay, the production line, okay, because of the customer, and you have to hire the employees because when the customer is getting numbers up, okay, and increasing indirectly, you have to hire the employees to help you in order to boost the production line, right? And then schedule meetings. We're talking about the meeting itself, how you want to make sure that what to improve, what the reason the company is making the meeting, because they want to improvise, they want to discuss on what's the current matters, okay? And of course, to lay fiber optic lines, okay, this is something like basically you can see numbers of customer is starting to queue up, okay, and engaging in any business activity. So this is very important, the process, okay, the process of the business started, and to tell and to point out the most important thing here from this statement is, without the customer, you don't have the business. So I believe on there must be the customer sides and also the employee side. So without the customer, you can't hire the employees, right? So without the customer, you can also have the business itself. So why the reason you hire the employees to help you to boost the production? And at the same time, you have to know also that the reason you hire the employees because you want to persuade the customer, right? You want to make them satisfied with your products and also services. Okay, now we're moving on to the deming emphasize on the customer. So we do have the multiples of the stages here. We have suppliers, inputs, outputs, and also the customer. And also we have in the parts of inputs here, we have design and redesign. Okay, the reason we have design and redesign because this is the process, okay, whereby, mashallah, it's also at the night, because we do not know that certain the first design is sometimes is not very satisfied, okay. And also then what they did was they do some prototype and then they do some revision on that improvisation, and then they will start to redesign. And also we have the outputs. At the end of there will be outputs, and then they goes to the customer, and then the customer will keep on doing their consumer research. Okay, meaning to say they start to comparing, they start to analyze about your product, what the good things about your product, what is the weaknesses. And then that is goes with the process itself. So the in the parts of the outputs, actually, even though we already launching and selling the product, it doesn't mean that that is the end and that is the output, okay, the finalized output. It can be still, okay, have some changes on that. There akan ada juga proses kita panggil sebagai perubahan yang akan ada memerlukan masa untuk kita sentiasa ada penambahbaikan. You see, like technologies nowadays, we have handphone, we have computers, laptops. So all those things, even like textile, even like beverage industry, okay, what else? All kinds, pharmaceutical industry, all are involving the consumer research, and the output is not the finalized output. It will be have some changes. And this is the process, okay? Alright, so we're moving to the next one, which is a business case for the customer focus. So satisfaction is an attitude, loyalty is a behavior. So what is the difference? So how people will say attitude and behavior is same? Actually, it's not. Okay, so attitudes, if in Bahasa Melayu we call as tingkah laku. Okay, behavior sikap. Okay, it will be like, is it same? Is it's almost same. If we motive, we might say that it's same, but it's actually different, because satisfaction is about how your react after done, okay, with that, okay, after some action being taken, how do you react towards it, okay. Loyalty, of course, is also like after some action being taken, and then it start with satisfaction first, okay? Meaning to say, if you keep have consistent satisfaction, then you will have loyal. But if let's say, how to say that you are not loyal because you are not satisfied. So it start with the first one first, okay? So meaning to say, satisfaction is an attitude, then loyalty is behavior. So they must be triggered by satisfaction, then they have loyalty. Kalau tak ada satisfaction, takkan ada loyalty. So it interrelated, okay? And loyal customers spend more because why? Once they believe and have a high trust, okay, towards one product or services they use, they will spend more. They don't even calculate it on that. Dia takkan ada perasaan berkira-kira sebab dia dah percaya. Dia dah letakkan kepercayaan yang tinggi pada produk ataupun pada perkhidmatan yang mereka gunakan. Okay, and they are willing to pay higher prices. So meaning to say they don't even bother because they know how this product, how this service will react, and they don't mind to spend more. And then they will refer new clients, okay, and are less costly to do business with. Okay, meaning to say because the loyal customer, we don't need to spend a lot of time with them. Are you get me? Meaning to say you don't need to bother about to keep on doing marketing, okay, and keep on promoting, okay, this product is like this, because they already know, okay, they are in the know on that. And then it costs 5 times more to find a new customer than to keep an existing one happy. So they said when we want to find the new customer, it takes around, this is according to Kotler's, if I'm not mistaken, the fathers of marketing said, if they cost 5 times more, dia memerlukan kos 5 kali ganda untuk mendapatkan customer baru berbanding dengan untuk kita mengekalkan customer yang happy, which is the loyal customer. So that's why when we already have the loyal customer, we have to keep them good care. Kita kena jaga mereka lah dengan sebaik mungkin. And a firm cannot create the loyal customer without first creating satisfied customer. So that's why I told you just now, the loyalty is start from the satisfaction and it's triggered by the satisfaction. So if you want your customer to be loyal, first, you must satisfy them first, okay? Okay, and because why? The rule is like this. To create a new customer, it takes 5 times cost. Okay, 5 kali ganda cost. And in order to already get the loyal customer, you have to maintain them, take care of them, okay? About everything they want, of course. And then, of course, we cannot create the loyal customer if we are not satisfied by them. How they want to make sure that they are all loyal? Because they have to satisfy first. That is the rules, okay? All right, so we're moving on to the next one, the importance of the supplier. So this is basically a fundamental part. Benda yang paling asas. Sebab bila kita nak jual produk kita, kita kena dapat supplier yang baik, baru kita dapat menawarkan harga yang baik. If we want to offering at the reasonable price, okay, to make sure that our customer is satisfied with our product and also quality product, first and the foremost, we have to take care of our supplier. So what is the importance of the supplier? Number one, quality of the supply chain affect the quality that the customer receive. So meaning to say, it affect the quality that the customer receive, meaning to say the supply chain, rantaian pengedaran tersebut. Okay, it must be number one, quality, to make sure that the customer also receive the same quality product or quality services. Number two, superior quality, consistent service and competitive pricing are just the price of entry to get into the game. Sorry. Okay, when we're talking about, okay, when talking about this business, right, it's something like a game, you know. I'm not saying that that is the place to hide and seek, no. But this is the game that we have to competing with the others. Because you have to remember, in the business, we are not the only champion. We are not the only one dominant in that business because we are the new entrant. Somehow, maybe we are only the small portion of the market share that contributes to the market share. We are the only one the company that only contribute to very small portion of the market share. Kita ni hanya mungkin sebahagian daripada kek sahaja yang menyumbang kepada pasaran, kita kata market share lah. Orang kata rantaian pasaran tu sebenarnya. And they said in here superior quality, meaning to say your quality must be on top notch, kena yang terbaik lah. And then your service must be consistent, made on time, okay, and then competitive pricing, because of course the customer keep comparing the price with your competitors, okay. And the third one, the suppliers must continually improve and align their operation with the customer needs, okay. So the supplier part, okay, they have to make sure also they keep on improving, improvise. I like to use the word improvise, mean to say keep on improving, okay, and then to make sure that your operation will align with the customer needs. If let's say the supplier dealing and deliver their resources at not in the right time, let's say, right, and the customer demand is already high and peak, okay, and what happened, okay, maybe you cannot meet the deadline, you may be promising the customer the product will be arrived and delivered to your house within 2 days. After all, the pending come from the suppliers is 2 days. So how you want to meet the target? So that's why they have to be aligned. Dia kena selari, consistent. Kalau tak, apa yang dijanjikan pada customer tak consistent dengan apa supplier buat. Selalunya, the worst problem or the problematic part is when, why the supplier not meet the deadline, because the maybe there is a conflict on producing the raw materials, or maybe in terms of the payment is delayed, okay, it can be, or maybe in terms of logistic itself, maybe logistic from, maybe you import the product from China and all of a sudden the conditions of the weather, logistic problem, okay, it's not arrived and delivered at the right time. It can be happen. So this is the thing that we have to predict actually when it comes to the quality of the supplier. Okay, now the principle for the customer supplier relationship. Okay, so if you can see from here, the first one in here, the recognitions of the strategy importance of the customer and suppliers. Okay, okay, basically this statement is a very basic statement. Okay, how we want to make sure that the strategy importance of the customer and supplier, we must have recognition in here. Okay, recognition in here mean you have to appreciate them. Okay, like I said before, payment is very important. Payment, when you order the some resources, raw materials from your suppliers, make sure your payment is aligned with what you get. That is number one. So they feel that you have like mutually trust towards them, consensus business, and then you've been recognized. And of course, they must be quality product. Okay, you have to keep on telling them, okay, I want the quality product, make sure it's grade A, do not change the grade, okay, do not do some fraudulent, so dealing with the owner's business, okay. And then the second one, development of the win-win relationship between the customer and supplier. So this is the so-called mutual consensus trust, okay, because we want to make sure that you also get the profit, I also get the profit. That is a win-win situation. I pay for the quality of what I want, you give and deliver to us the quality that what I expected from you. So that is win-win situation, okay. And then the third one, establishing relationship based on trust. So meaning to say, when the company is ordered raw materials from you, you sending and deliver it on time, and when the raw materials is delivered to you, the payment also on time. So meaning to say, we have trust. Okay, what happened if there is no trust, there is no consensus or mutual trust among of them? Okay, there will be problem. Okay, meaning to say there will be a problem on that. Okay, there will be have some conflict. So the reason we must have trust on that. Okay, now we're moving to the next one. Okay, practices for dealing with the customer. Just now with supplier, collect information constantly on the customer expectation. So you can do some like survey. You can do like right now we can do some like online survey, right? Okay, maybe if you realize even a very prominent brand names, even when you're watching YouTube, right, you're viewing some videos in YouTube, they do some like a very simple survey. Do you recognize this product on YouTube? So you are actually indirectly collecting information from the customer, whether product shampoo, whether product anything product that I realize, okay? And somehow they pop up when you are open up your sign in into your social media accounts, right? For example, like Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and LinkedIn, okay? So this is what basically they did, okay? And then when you open up like a website, the pop-ups, advertisement, that one is not advertisements, of course, sometimes they call as online survey. So that is how they collect information constantly, okay? And then the second one, disseminate this information widely within the organizations. So meaning to say, when we say disseminate, you are spreading, menyebarkan, okay, maklumat secara meluas, okay, from within the organization to make sure that the customer receive and receiving the right information. Okay, because we don't want to people interpret falsely, okay, and then maybe they miss false of the information. So make sure it come from the right sources. And then the third one, use this information to design, produce, and deliver the organization product and services. So whereby they're using this information, that's why this from the information they can design, okay, they can produce, and also the best one, they can deliver it, okay. And then the fourth one, manage the customer relationship. So when we're talking about manage customer relationship, meaning to say the relationship between the customer also, it can be built. If let's say like website, right, let's say you promoting or selling your product through website of the company, so actually from the database you can manage the customer relationship. You can know their details, their information, and then you know how to actually create some a good relationship with them. Let's say when they're purchasing your product, and then during their birthday, okay, you can give something like discount code or discount percentage, okay, they can get some promotion price due to their birthday. So this is how actually that you can manage a win-win situation with the customer, so the customer feel appreciated and also recognized. Or maybe you can giving some like promotion to early birds customer. So that is also so called how you can manage the customer relationship, okay? And then you make how the payment system very flexible. It's not only just one bank, or they have multiple and flexible bank. You can use like debit card, or you can use credit cards. It's how do we sometimes I realize certain of the website they can use like TM touch, okay, but they can use touch and go, they can use the boost, okay. So it's good because the more flexible the payment system, actually you you're calling and pulling some of the potential new customer, okay. And then exploit CRM technology, okay. What's been CRM, customer relationship management technology? So we can use have maybe as I mentioned just now, by using social media technology, okay. And even though we can use also like face-to-face and like so-called now we have the virtual, right? You can invite them to like webinar, or you can invite them something like call as Facebook Live, okay? And then you can have some like to know the customer more lively, even though it's virtual world right now. And then don't ignore the internal customer. Internal customer meaning to say it's within your company itself, okay? besides you have the employees and staff, they also become your potential customer and somehow the suppliers itself. And of course, we're talking about internal customer itself, the people have the vested interest towards your company yang mempunyai minat yang mendalam lah. Kita kata mereka mempunyai hubungan-hubungan tertentu dengan syarikat kita. Tak kisahlah, sometimes it can be like media, okay, it can be like a stakeholders, okay, and also of course it's supposed to the nearly to the shareholder itself. Okay, now we're moving on how to collect the customer information. Indirectly, you are learning like form principle of marketing subject, you know, or maybe it can like consumer behavior subject in here. Okay, so number one, collect customer information. Macam mana kita nak mengumpulkan maklumat customer ni? Okay, pertama, comment cards and formal survey. So this is a very we can say a prominent methodology, okay, approach, okay, whereby you can give them some cards and then they will comment. But nowadays, due to the technology, okay, high advances technology, we can use these comment cards by making up and creating like comments using e-cards, okay, and then maybe like a formal survey rather than we have this formal survey, we have online survey, and maybe you can have like a snapshot during maybe giving some videos, and then you can actually together slip it together and then you can ask them for like information from the customer. They have many ways right now, okay, and then you also we can use Google form, okay, and you also can encourage them in order to get like recognize them by giving like e-certificate, okay, and then by having like how to say that, fill out the form and then you can get e-certificate, or maybe you can get e-voucher on that. So they have multiples promotion strategy on how you want to collect the information of the customer. And second one, we have the focus group. This is a very important because we want to know who is our target market. I recap back in my subject consumer behavior, we have STP, segmentation, targeting and positioning. When we're talking about the focus group, is referring to T, which is targeting, okay, who is the customer who willing to pay your product. I always use the example as like who is paying for the baby's pampers, for example, right? So some say, when I say who is the customer for the pampers, baby pampers, they say baby. Do the baby is paying their own pampers? No, the parents. So the parents with the babies is actually the focus group. So when we're talking about this focus group, meaning to say, they will be give you 100% honest, okay, how to say that, response, because they are the one who pay for your product or services. So focus group is very important because we want to make sure that these people, because they are buying your product, right, they use your service, so they will actually give the honest response towards your service. Okay, that is number two. Number three, direct customer contact. Call, okay? Like I say, interview. Do some short webinar, for example, okay? To pull them together. Or maybe do some online pool survey, okay? Direct customer contact. Call them and ask them. So most probably, many customers, they hate when there is a lot of telemarketers call them because they have, maybe they do some errands to do, right? But you call them, you take their time. Even though you might say, sir, madam, can you spend around 2 to 3 minutes? Hear your voice and how the way you approach sometimes is annoying, right? So how the way this is direct customer contact is a very difficult to do, but somehow telemarketers able to do it a different way right now, okay? Not only necessary direct contact through handphone, okay, mobile phone from house, home number, or maybe they can use some emails, okay, and maybe social media, okay? They have many various ways right now, huh? And then field intelligence, meaning to say we go to the right fields, okay, the practitioner, okay, we collect the informations and then the customer will tell you, okay, what they really want about these products, okay, the quality of the product itself, the services, and complete analysis. This is a very important because we will get this one from the customer service department, yeah, because the complaints actually it's triggered to why the customer complains. That is the question, kan? Dia akan tanya kenapa customer complains. There must be a reason. So we look into the analysis. Okay, oh, the customer complains about the packaging. The customer complains about the payment system. The customer complains about the website is not user friendly. Or maybe the customer will complain about the postage is take a long time. And maybe you should change your postage or courier services. So there have lots of the complaint analysis on this. Okay, so the company itself, we have to become a very, what we call, transparent and flexible. We not just jump into conclusion and say, if the customer don't want to buy, up to you, don't buy. Don't say that, because we mentioned it just now, right? To remain a loyal customer is not very easy, and to get a new customer it needs 5 times cost. Jadi nak 1,000 daya tak nak 1,000 dali. Okay, and then the internet monitoring. So basically this one, the most effective way. Okay, since we during this pandemic, okay, we do have like a lot of platform, even though like Lazada, Shopee, they have their own how the monitoring system, we can see the percentage the customer during maybe since start with the March 2020, right? The pandemic until now. If you remember yesterday is till 1st August, right? It's 500 days already we are in this pandemic in Malaysia, okay, pandemic COVID-19. So can you imagine that? During that particular 500 days, how many the customer is actually have response towards your product or services. Of course, at the earlier stage, it takes time because people not so very familiar with those function features of your company websites. After they already have familiar, and then the words of mouth from the customers, okay, they keep on have like juggling, okay, a lot of people know how to know about this product, so they respond towards you. Okay, okay, now we're moving on to the understand the customer needs, the Kano model. So in this subject there have a lot of the model that you have to remember. Okay, basically of course to in the know, so you can have that knowledge, okay, on that. Okay, so the Kano model stated they have dissatisfiers. Maksudnya orang tidak puas hati. So they expected requirement. Why do have this dissatisfiers? Kenapa ada pelaku yang tidak puas hati? Jadi dia ada sesuatu yang dia harapkan, yang dia jangkakan untuk ada supaya dia satisfied. So satisfied express the requirement. Orang-orang ini adalah yang memberitahu. Dia memberitahu secara langsung apa yang dia hendak. Macam dia dissatisfiers ni, dia tak bagi tahu, tetapi dia lebih kepada menjangkakan, expected. So kita bukannya zaman yang kita boleh baca akal fikiran orang, kan? Jadi mungkinlah dari segi bila dia buat survey, mereka boleh jangkakan, tetapi untuk for the first trial, so it's not expecting that everybody know, I mean the company know. So the satisfied is expressed to the requirement, and then exciters or delighters, unexpected features. So orang-orang ni adalah yang mereka tidak menjangkakan sehebat ni, ataupun delighters. Jadi what they receive is more than expected. Jadi dia akan jadi macam wow. Jadi kita nak dapat yang exciters and delighters is very rare, but once kita dapat, insyaAllah there will become okay, even though I can do it's one video, but I will do it's two parts. I don't want to make your video very like, you know, very very like mashallah, like very too long. But inshallah I will come back to you back for the second part. Stay safe everyone, get your vaccination, please flatten the curve, stay at home, please take care. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye bye.